Hello, it's Ranger Emily here with Manhattan Project National Historical Park. I'm going to remove my mask so you can hear me better. For today's pop-up playday video, we are learning about pets and animals of the Manhattan Project and how animals helped the United States war effort during World War II. Before the Manhattan Project, the indigenous people who lived in the Tri-Cities area fished and hunted animals. Fishing was and is an important part of the Tri-Cities culture and economy. General Leslie Groves, the person in charge of the Manhattan Project, understood how important fishing is to people living in Washington, and he took steps to protect salmon during the time of the Manhattan Project. The reason General Groves was worried about salmon specifically is because Chinook salmon spawn in the Columbia River near the Manhattan Project site. By order of General Groves, Manhattan Project scientists studied the spawning and health of salmon. Animals and pets played an important role in the Manhattan Project community. Many community members were far from home and isolated. Pets were considered members of the family and provided great comfort. Pets entertained people and lifted spirits. The Manhattan Project community even held pet shows and pet parades through the streets of Richland. The military also used cute cats and dogs as mascots to help lift spirits during wartime. But the military didn't just use animals as mascots. Animals served the military in many ways. During World War II, American soldiers used thousands of mules to carry equipment and people. Mules were especially valuable in North Africa, Italy, and East Asia because they could walk many miles over rough terrain. In East Asia, mules were more useful than jeeps because they could adapt to their surroundings. Mules could walk through jungles, climb mountains, and swim rivers, all while carrying 300 pounds of equipment. They were so popular with soldiers that the military put out a manual on what to look for in a mule. A mule was supposed to have tough feet, strong straight legs, and be good at keeping its balance. It was also important that the mule be calm because soldiers would use the mule during battle. Mule handlers were the soldiers who trained and took care of the mules. They trained mules near airplanes and trucks so the mules could get used to the sounds and smells of machines. Soldiers moved equipment with mule trains. A mule train is a line of mules carrying or pulling equipment or people. Mule handlers train mule trains to follow the sound of the bell mare. The bell mare gets its name from the bell it wears around its neck. The mule train follows the sound of the bell mare wherever she goes. Soldiers preferred mules over horses during World War II because mules are such good pack animals and smarter and calmer than horses. Mules replaced many horses abroad during World War II, but horses were still important to the war effort, especially here in the United States. During World War II, military leaders worried about Japanese and Germans landing on American beaches, and they had a good reason to worry. German submarines had already sunk several American ships off the East Coast by 1942. That same year, two groups of German spies landed on the beaches of New York and Florida. In New York, the arrest of the Germans was delayed by the Coast Guard Patrol having to search for the men on foot. These events highlighted America's need to patrol and protect its coast, and horses were the solution to the problem. Horses are fast and they can chase people and deliver messages much quicker than humans can. Because the military was replacing horses with mules abroad, the Army was able to immediately give the Coast Guard thousands of horses. By 1943, 3,000 horses were part of the U.S. Coast Guard. Dogs also helped patrol American beaches. 18,000 dogs served in the U.S. military during World War II. Unlike other countries like France, the U.S. didn't have a war dog program until World War II. In 1942, the military began the Dogs for Defense program. The Dogs for Defense program recruited dogs for military use. Many Americans volunteered their dog for the program. Dogs had to first pass intelligence and health tests before they could join the military. Today, the police and military mostly use German Shepherds. But during World War II, all types of dogs were part of the Dogs for Defense program. The military had five main categories of dogs. The five categories were scout dogs, sentry, or what we call guard dogs, messenger dogs, mine detection dogs, and attack dogs. Dog handlers trained all dogs as sentry dogs. Dogs would then get further specialized training to become a messenger, scout, attack, or mine detection dog. It was the job of the sentry and scout dogs to protect the soldiers. The scout dogs walked ahead of the soldiers and silently warned the soldiers of other people or danger. Messenger dogs carried messages in canisters around their neck. they could deliver a message 4 to 5 times faster than a person running on foot. Dogs are also smaller than humans and harder to catch. Messenger dogs were the only dogs with 2 handlers. The messenger dog would deliver a message from one handler to the other handler and not have to question who to deliver the message to. The military did not consider the attack dog or the mine dog programs to be a success. The 2 programs failed because the dogs were not properly trained. At the time, the military was unaware that dogs could smell explosives. Instead, they trained dogs to find bombs using their eyes and not their powerful noses. Smokey, a Yorkshire Terrier, is one of the most famous dogs to serve in World War II. An American soldier found Smokey in the jungles of New Guinea. For the next 2 years, Smokey flew with Corporal William A. Wynn on combat flights in the Pacific. Smokey survived the typhoon, parachuting, and 150 air raids. She also saved Corporal Wynn's life by warning him of danger. Smokey is most famous for helping the Signal Corps run a telegraph wire through a 70-foot-long pipe. Corporal Wynn said, "I tied a string, tied to the wire, to Smokey's collar, and ran to the other end of the culvert. Smokey made a few steps in and then ran back. 'Come, Smokey,' I said sharply, and she started through again. When she was about 10 feet in, the string caught up, and she looked over her shoulder as much to say, 'What's holding us up there?' The string loosened from the snag, and she came on again. By now, the dust was rising from the shuffle of her paws as she crawled through the dirt and mold, and I could no longer see her. I called and pleaded, not knowing for certain whether she was coming up or not. At last, about 20 feet away, I saw 2 little amber eyes, and I heard a faint whimpering sound. At 15 feet away, she broke into a run. We were so happy at Smokey's success that we patted and praised her for a full 5 minutes. Smokey saved 250 lives by crawling through the tunnel. The soldiers would have had to spend 3 days fixing the pipe, which would have put them in grave danger. Smokey's story made her famous in the U.S. She became a performer after World War II and traveled the world. After the war, the military trained dogs like Smokey to return their owners, and the military did its best to unite service dogs with their owners. Like dogs and horses, the military used homing pigeons to deliver messages. People have used pigeons to deliver messages for 2,000 years, beginning with the Romans. Pigeons were the most successful messenger of World War II with a 90% success rate. Submarines, airplanes, and ships all used homing pigeons. Pigeons are great messengers because they are hard to detect and catch. Using animals to deliver messages was safer and more reliable than using radios. The U.S. used 54,000 pigeons during World War II. 3,000 soldiers and 150 officers were assigned to the U.S. Military Pigeon Service. The military even used bats and spiders during World War II. Project X-Ray was a secret military project to strap small bombs to bats and drop them out of airplanes over Japan. The bats would release from the container and hide in the rooftops and buildings. The bombs would then explode, catching the buildings on fire. Project X-Ray was risky, and the military did not pursue the bat bombs for several reasons. Though the idea of bat bombs may seem strange, they did work somewhat. Unfortunately, one of the bat bomb experiments resulted in burning down the brand new Carlsbad Army Airfield Auxiliary Air Base. Spiders were also used during World War II. Soldiers at Fort Knox caught spiders on base and sent them to Ohio for thread production. The military used spider silk for instruments. For example, spider silk, or web, was used to make crosshairs and gun scopes. Spider silk is a superior material because it's strong, flexible, lightweight, and difficult to break. Black widow spiders produce the best thread for instruments. During World War II, animals served bravely. They protected soldiers, and many of them sacrificed their lives for the United States. Military leaders appreciated and respected service animals so much that they gave animals military ranks, and animals outranked their handlers by 1 rank. Animals served as companions to both soldiers abroad and people living in the United States during World War II. Pets brought happiness and cheer to the Manhattan Project community and soldiers fighting abroad. Thank you for joining me for today's Pop-Up Playdays video about pets in our community. For our next Pop-Up Playdays, we'll be talking about art in our community. Don't forget to complete this week's passport activity so you can earn your Junior Ranger patch or pin. I'll see you next time.